We live in a world where there's more information than anybody knows what to do with. It's so cheap. We can share it instantaneously around the world, and yet it's hard to find the information we need when we want it. You can think about the School of Information as being engaged in the big challenges of information abundance, information ubiquity.
While technology is at the core of many of the things we do, it's only at the core, and it's really the custard that surrounds it that gives the place its meaning.
How do you take information and make it easy to understand and to work with? How do you visualize it? How do you communicate your findings with policymakers who are going to make decisions based on it?
Technology is just too consequential to be left to engineers. You need other kinds of understanding. You need to understand the technology, social, economic, political, that it's embedded in.
People come here for different reasons. Some people are really interested in like user experience and design, user research. Some people were already like software engineers and they just kind of want to get more of a flavor of designing.
We're a pretty small community here, so it's really easy to get to know people, and not just on a social level, but also kind of to improve your professional outlook in the future, think about your goals, like, and get more ideas from each other.
Because of the flexibility of the program, there's only a few required courses, and so you can really decide what you're going to take.
I think it's valuable for the students to have people come in from industry just for them to get a sense of really what's happening out there. The book I wrote was about designing the iPhone user experience, but the class is much broader.
So why add sound to your apps?
I think the most applicable sounds for us would be just like keyboard presses, like that kind of feedback.
Perhaps when you mark some of your outfits as favorites, we can have a little sound effect.
The class is project-based. The students are grouped into teams and they're all designing their own app over the course of the semester.
The attractiveness of the iSchool to me was that I had the opportunity to do all of these different things and kind of pick and choose from the buffet of things that I might find interesting.
We strongly encourage our master's students to come in with a couple of years' experience, at least. I think they get more out of this program if they do it. I think that they have more to offer. There are really tremendous advantages in being here in Berkeley and in the Bay Area.
There's an extraordinary confluence of worlds here. On the one hand, you're in the middle of one of the three or four greatest universities in the world. And there are first-rate scholars in everything from history to physics to law to business and so on. So that's an extraordinary environment to be in.
I think it's even deeper than that. The culture here, the openness of the culture, the lack of traditional hierarchies that you find in older parts of the U.S. is very supportive of the kind of experimentation, learning by doing, entrepreneurial attitudes that we find are so successful in today's economy.
The iSchool is really well known in the Bay Area, and part of it is because of where alumni have ended up. I have my job in no small part because one of my professors not just encouraged me, but literally made the email introductions. There's a lot of reciprocity in sort of the ecosystem. So, you know, there are a lot of opportunities for us to kind of come back.
And we draw them back in for activities. They come and help students find jobs. The alumni are really a core asset.
Having this great combination of proximity to where the magic happens in the industry and access to best-in-class professors and academia resources. It was what motivated my final decision.
We bring in bright people with great backgrounds. We put them together in pretty intense experiences, and by the end, they often produce things that we could never have imagined. We're at the very beginning. The generations that come through the iSchool will be pioneers in that revolution, but it will last for many generations.